want to know the scoop on the next season, all the secrets, everything you can
everything.
Tell us.
Just I'll tell you the whole season.
Yes.
Just pitch you the whole thing. Here's what I'll tell you. I'm very excited, having been given the opportunity to run the show now, to take what really works about Van Helsing, keep the DNA of it, keep the roots, but kind of grow it in a new and different direction. So my mandate this season was to bring a whole bunch of new cast in to sort of reinvigorate our cast with some interesting new characters. I wanted to take us into places that we've never been before. So some of the locations we've shot in this season, some of the looks of the episodes in terms of how we shot them, very, very different. And still, it's still Van Helsing. And that's been a great and exciting challenge to kind of push the show, to try and turn a corner a little bit with the show and have people feel like, oh wow, season four, it's got some fresh energy.
Was introducing the character of Dracula all along something you guys thought of doing?
Well, the previous showrunner, Neil LaBute, who's been a really fantastic mentor for me, and encouraged me, you know, encouraged everyone to let me have this job in the first place, very early on said, well, we're making a vampire show, eventually Dracula's gonna pop up. And it was actually him, I think, from very early in season one in the writing room said, Dracula should be a woman. Wouldn't that be interesting? I don't think I've really seen that before. Let's play with that idea. So even though we've waited until season four to finally bring Dracula into our storytelling, it was the right choice. And then, you know, we had this remarkable opportunity to get Trisha to be part of the show. And it was like, that's an amazing Dracula.
Yeah.
Let's do that. So we leaned into it.
Last season, there was a lot of separate storylines going on. Are they more gelled together this coming season?
Well, because we're exploring new characters, there's a certain amount of legwork responsible for setting up those characters and the arcs where they're going. So we do have some overlap of storylines, and we do have a bunch of times where our characters kind of team up to do certain things.
Mm-hmm.
But there is still a little bit of breaking out storylines because, you know, kind of like a show like Game of Thrones, it's hard to have a large ensemble cast and put them all on the same story track. It's a lot of sort of mouths to feed proverbially in terms of storytelling. So it's a pretty effective tool for us to kind of send them off on different quests or have them tied up or caught up in something over here while these other people are doing something else over here. And so there's a little of that, but I think you'll find there's a bit more cohesion in places this season with some of our main players.
Is there a chance for, you know, new viewers? Is that something you're looking to try and get to bring in season four, kind of changing it around a little bit, bringing in a new audience as well as the, you know, loyal fans?
I would love to bring in a new audience to build on what we have. You know, obviously now we're in an era where it used to be with network television, if you couldn't catch up, you just had to drop into a show and try and figure out where it was. Now we've got the whole inventory of episodes available on Netflix and Syfy, and you can kind of dive in. But very key strategic decision for me was, you'll notice that a couple of our new female leads are early mid-20s, and I thought, boy, that was an underrepresented category in our show. We had a lot of actors that were over 35 and fair number that were over 45, and I thought, if I can do anything, I want to draw in some younger eyeballs to the show. So adding some youth to the cast was a big mandate of mine. Plus also adding characters like, you know, Richard Harmon, who most people know from The 100,
mm-hmm.
an old friend of mine who we did Continuum together, and I thought, he's a get, because again, he's got a big following in the under 30 crowd, and having him be part of the show has been fantastic.
Are there going to be any really unusual teaming up of characters that we might not expect?
Yes.
Okay, what?
What I will tell you is definitely some lines of who's in what camp is going to blur.
Okay.
And that doesn't just mean for vampires, that means for the humans as well. This idea that there's questions about how to move forward in this world. It's not as cut and dry as we're humans, so we're against the vampires and they're against us. Those lines really, really get blurred this season. One of the things for sure, you know, obviously there's, I don't know if you were able to see the trailer that we put up for our panel, but there's a lot of ill will between Axel and Vanessa. You know, he blamed her at the end of season 3 for being responsible completely responsible for Scarlet's death. And so as a result, he's got an axe to grind. So that's an interesting break, because he'd always been the one who was the protector. And now he's not happy.
She just wrapped. She just did her finger, yeah. I mean, we keep going.
Yeah, yeah. Sorry, you asked me away if you got any other questions.
You're speaking about bringing in a younger audience, and I'm curious to know how social media is coming into play with that, if you are using social media to kind of attract a younger audience.
Yeah. Social media is massive, obviously, with the under 30 crowd, and you do need to build a profile with them if you want to draw them, and certainly adding actors who have got a following already is super helpful with that. In terms of our social media strategy, we're still a little bit on the low end of the curve, because we do have a couple of social media accounts, and we do try and put stuff out and get people excited about it, but certainly it's adding younger actors who've got a following has been very helpful. Because there's just suddenly an awareness of like, oh god, Richard Harmon's on Van Helsing, and a bunch of people migrate over. So that's my hope, is just that, we can open it up to some new people this season.
Tone-wise, is this season darker than previous seasons, or...?
It's certainly darker in the sense that Dracula's arrived. But one of the things I always love about genre is when you find ways to still have humor and still have levity and still have people trying to make the best of bad situations. And so, tonally, I think there's a little bit of both this season.